under trading newsletters.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi, everyone. Basil Chapman on this. Let me just get this done here. On this 25th day of March, almost wrapping the month of, what a month, wow. With the Dow up 681 at 21,395 towards the upper end of the day's session. Remember, in the weekly chart, I had drawn this pattern of an arch potential that can go all the way to the 22,500s. Could even go higher, but it's an arch pattern because it could fail. Or a V-shaped pattern. We won't know for a little while whether it's the V-shaped pattern or the arch pattern. First, we have to get the rally. We have to get a, there's just so much news coming out over the next, I would say 24 hours. That it's just really difficult to say. But on a purely sentiment basis, let me just do this quickly. The VIX index is holding actually quite nicely here. It's down 35 cents at 61.30. Just 61. Can you believe it? Normally, we're looking at ranges in the teens. And it had a high of 85.37. The TVIX, which I've spoken about so often, is two times long. The volatility index had a round number 1,000.00, amazing, high. Oh, I should have put the date in. I think it was the 16th, 18th. Let me just put that in here, edit. Okay, Okay, so that is very interesting because that was on the 3/18/20. I'm making a note of this because I'm thinking that this could be at least multi-week high, maybe even more. But the reason why I say that is that we could see the market go lower, but you don't have to, that sentiment indicator was so high. You remember just everything came together, the increase in Italy of deaths, not just numbers of potential victims, but deaths. That makes a difference. Okay, so it had everything. Uncertainty in the market and all the rest. And that signaled that that was an emotional, and this is two times long, so you really get people who play this already playing odds, and they got the wrong odds because the one who bought it at 1,000, that's going to, I wonder if that's going to turn out to be like the Qualcomm of the 2020s. Remember Qualcomm in 2000? It screamed up to an incredible high, and whoever got the top tick there. Now it's been smoothed out because there was, let me show you this chart here. This is Qualcomm in the tech area, and it made a high way back of 100 round number high on the 1st of January of 2000. It wasn't 100. I'm not sure what the number was because it had a split at some point after that. And so I don't remember what it was, but it was incredibly high. It was one of the highest priced stocks at that particular time. And someone bought the top tick. There was rumor that it was a particular person, a surgeon or something, oral surgeon, I don't know what it was. A surgeon who bought the top tick, and he bought it having remortgaged his house or mortgage or whatever it was. He did a terrible thing and put all that money into Qualcomm. And it wasn't very long before, not only was he divorced, but he had lost everything. That's the story. You always have to have a story. So let's just go back. So the volatility index is saying, on a purely emotional level, we've made some kind of an internal high. Now there has to be some kind of a retest. Doesn't have to, but usually there is a retest. I'm suspecting that it could be lower, not if the deaths really increase a lot. But at this point, you're getting an increase in deaths. We're just going to have to monitor that. All right, here we go. So the Dow up 650 at 21,358 is acting well. It 21,745 is the 40 period. This is the black line, 40 period exponential moving average. The pink line is 20,912. That'll be very short-term support right now. It said monthly. It's a weekly chart that's that really has to rally. And this monthly chart, if it can produce a, I'll talk about tomorrow's technical Friday. Friday's technical Friday. We'll get into that then. So we've got that. We've got the S&P. The S&P is trading up 35.76 at 24.82. It's right just above the pink 9-period exponential moving average. The MACD's turned up and hasn't crossed positive. Stochastic's still really very weak at 14%. On-balance volume has turned up nicely. It's a good sign. But at 25.59, in other words, 25.60 is a 9, is a 14-period moving average. It needs to start trading above it, not cross above it, trading above it. And that's going to be important. And this weekly candle so far is improving a lot. QQQ NDX 100 trading vehicle, the Invesco QQQ Trust Series trading up 47. Oh, that's better than just a few minutes ago. At 184.15, there's still not a great candle so far. It's just a doji candle at a doji low at the 154.93 level, 154.93. On the, I should put a date on the 23rd. Oh, I remember that. On the 23rd of March, and it touched the 14-period moving average, hit 187.10, it's trading at 184.23 right now, 186.04 is the 14-period moving average. I want it trading in the 187.88 area and holding there on a closing basis. You've got the IWM, the little IWM is trading a little better than the others. No, it isn't. I thought it was. It's up $1.13 at 110.13. The MACD is improving. It hasn't crossed positive, and the stochastic's at 14%. It has to get to 23% to really start to show some oomph. And 115.50s is a level to get to hit the 14-period moving average. Now I want to go to TLT. I usually go to this later. I'll go to it now because trading up 2.12 and 165.05 says that money should be coming out of stocks into bonds, but it isn't. It's coming into stocks and it's coming into bonds. What a crazy market. So if there's a move, I think I'd say to subscribers, if there's a move above 166, let me check. Yeah, if it can get above the 166s, in other words, it could start leg B above exactly 166.69, not just start, it really has to get to 167, 168. And that'll say, yields are going to be coming down. I think yields are kind of stuck in a range for now. And we'll see very soon. And at this particular point, if there's a turn down in bonds and bonds start to slide underneath 158 is really the level. If it starts to close under 158, there's a good chance it'll go lower and yields will go a little bit higher. So it's a tough situation now because you've got money being poured into the stock market. And will it come out of bonds or it doesn't have to stay in bonds? That's the big question. Let's look at the crude oil. Crude oil right now is trading down 3 cents at 23.98. It's just stuck in that lower range. You just don't want to see it trading under 20. That'll be, remember, it was quite some time ago I was asked about it, and I said, my outlook for crude oil, and not giving you a time, but I think my outlook is to go into the teens as batteries and all the other accoutrements that you got for energy start to come online and with natural gas and everything. Just, there's a lot of pressure for crude oil. This was quite quick, and it's kind of, that's a big move down. I'll be back. We talk about gold, talk about the dollar, the euro. We'll be back, and we've got a lot to talk about.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN is launching an open house for our Tiger's Den. For a limited time, you can get a 30-day free trial to the Tiger's Den. Just enter promo code OPEN at checkout and pay nothing for 30 days while you try out your Tiger's Den membership as part of our open house. With market volatility at an all-time high and people all over the world working from home if possible, TFNN is hosting an open house in our Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is an interactive chat room that runs all day where other tigers and tigresses discuss trading ideas with the hosts and members, along with charts and current market news, as well as live access to the charts the hosts use during their programs. Join us for the Tiger's Den Open House. Begin your den membership today by just entering OPEN at checkout and pay nothing while you try things out for 30 days. For all the details and to start your den membership today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the TFNN Tiger's Den Open House taking place now. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hey folks, Dow's up 744, S&P's up 46. What a day. I mean, up and down, up and down. Okay, so we're looking at, I just wanted to show you this. I had a question about the E-mini 10-minute chart. See the, this U-shaped pattern that makes another U that makes a W? I shown this chart earlier on when I came online about 15 minutes before the show starts. And I also typed in here that a rectangle formation can last a lot longer than your patience. Look at this. Basically, a rectangle pattern between 11 o'clock all the way through, and it just broke out about 12:06. But look at that range, just huge range, and then it just stays in this narrow, narrow confine. Amazing. It did make a peak G in the 2-minute chart at 20 to 10 this morning. Then it dropped very sharply from the 24.80. I think it was around about 24, was it 90, something like that. And then it dropped very sharply, I should remember, at 23.93 at 10.16 this morning. And then it went side up nicely to a peak D. Remember the Chapman Wave always look for four higher peaks? It can go all the way to E, F, and G, as you saw over there. But D is where other things can happen. What happened? Went sideways and started a brand new move, went to a peak D, and then just got stuck in this range between about 24.62 and around about 24.40. Just stuck there, and then boom, it screamed up. And all it has to do is go above the 24.75 level, oops, 24.86. That's what it was, 24.86. High of 22.10, and it will start in the 10-minute chart, which also went to a peak G, and then pull back to the 200-period exponential moving. That's the only reason why I have these moving averages, because they just give you so much information, like a candlestick. Just gives you a tremendous, went right there, tested it twice, and then started to move up, had a spectacular move up to the 24.80s, and then, bam, there was some news or something, went right back down to a slightly higher low, and that's the pink rising 200-period moving average. And now it's at a leg C, but that C gets eliminated immediately by reactivating the previous peak C that was the high of 24.86 at 20 to 10, which didn't take out its low, so this is still an active peak C, even though it got C minus. it has to just go 25 cents above, and that immediately becomes a peak D. Now, you might even get a Chapman wave overlapping wave that says you get a peak C, a pullback, and then it gets reactivated by rallying higher, and you get a double leg C, like an overlapping wave, or think of it as a kind of double, you know, cross current. And what we would look at is it goes to at least D before it pulls back again. So just wanted to show you that. I had a question about it by some people who use Chapman wave a lot. And now we're going to go back to our story. And the story says crude oil is kind of stuck. We've got high-grade copper tried to rally yesterday and then pull back. It rallied quite nicely, then it pulled back. Now it's filling in that wick from yesterday. It's up 0.03 at 2.213. It needs to get to 2.25 to break the pink 9-period moving average. Look at, you see, this is the reason why you use moving averages. Look how it, see the arch formation? That's exactly what you got in the 9, the 14-period moving averages all the way in February into early March before it broke down. Even as it broke down, that was your barrier. I love these things. These are, you know, just technical tools are fabulous. So that's it. Okay, now what we want to do is we want to say gold made a fractional new high today of 1699.3, a new high still under the 1704.3 high of February the 9th. In that V-shaped pattern, remember, I always say V-shaped patterns, they've got to break out decisively and have closes above the left side high. Otherwise, they tend to make double tops and pull back. Well, so far, this is acting very very much like expected, trying to rally above the 1704.3 level. Let me just check. It's a continuous contract. Was it smoothed out? Nope, still the same. And it pulled all, I mean, there's a huge move, two-day move from the 1490s all the way to the 1700s, and then pulls back today from 17, just under 1700 to a low of 1615. I remember talking about huge. Look at the left side. You know, look at that. It was just normal, regular action going in the middle of February, and then all of a sudden you get these huge moves. So we're watching this closely because could this be a little bit of a double top for time, maybe more than price? And I think yes. If you look at silver, silver's rallying today. It always plays catch up, and as soon as it starts to look quite good, they both start to come down. I'm watching it closely. Very nice rally, but look at the horrible down move. Trading at 14.68, up 42 cents. So now the support level is 14.30 to 13.90, the moving averages. And even more interesting is the dollar, Basil's dollar, trading down 28 cents at 101.76, still holding very well, all-time recovery high. Not a recovery high, not all-time high. All-time high was, well, 103.82 was the most important high. There was one before that went to 120. Let me see. Squeeze. There it is. 121.00, July of 2001. It also says that gets smoothed out. Yeah, 121. And then it plunged down to the 70 level and then traded between 70 for years and 91-ish before it broke out to the 103.82 high. So, yeah, this is a very, look, this is a huge, this is a magic, Aladdin's magic lamp. He has the big cup formation, a little bit of a handle, another handle, and we don't know what's going to happen next. But in the meantime, it's looking very good. Okay, so that's the dollar key supports between 101 and 100.20. Here we go. Okay, now we want to look at the TLT, that's bonds. So far, it looks like a potential double top, but that's just a potential double top. Why? Because it hit 179.70. Oh, wait a minute. Am I going to squeeze this? Am I looking at the right thing? No, I'm not. This is all-time highs in this contract. Okay, so it's broken out to the leg D. Can I make a peak D by having just a kind of a sideways move? We'll see. Oh, I did. I discussed this. I said above 166 starts to close in the 168 or higher level would be very good. The yields go down. If it comes back, it'll just, I think a rectangle formation trading range is really what I'm looking at. Now, I wanted to show you something with the EUR USD. So this is a little different. You see this Eiffel Tower, I call it the Eiffel Tower, straight up, straight down, looks like an uppercase A. If it takes out the left side low, that's usually very negative. It means that there's a lot of work to be done, and it could start to make that previous space some kind of a fulcrum going up and down like a sine wave below and above. So that's 1.077, trading right now at 1.083, trying to come back off the big, that very, very sharp, really, it looks like a crash, 1.15 down to 1.06. Oh, 1.06364. Wow, that's a big move. But it had a huge move up and a bigger move down. So that's the same if you look at the dollar. Look at the dollar. That weekly chart says it's screamed up. It hasn't made a new recovery high this week. Will it now do the same thing if the euro starts to rally? Well, all we can do is look at the euro as the dollar as it stands and say, holding very well. I'll be back. We'll look at some of these in greater detail. I have a lot of questions, and I'll try to get to them. And yes, that was a good.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the opening call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The opening call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, an essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the opening call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. So the E-mini 2-minute is at 53, is up 53 at 24.90. It seems to be right here in leg D. It's going to make a peak D and have another little bit of an hiatus. It had a peak D, so far two peak D tops on the way up since the low that was made at about 10.30. Let's see what happens. Doesn't have to. I'm just saying this is what I'm looking at. MACD is still very good. Stochastic's really strong at 94. I do have one signal that says just be a little careful right here. It's probably a little bit of hiatus. I'll be right back to that. Let's go on to so we're talking about the euro. So USD JPY. I'm going to do this because it's a little easier for me. This is a leg C, and you've had four higher highs very close to one another as it's starting to arch over. It's at 111.57. Can, just like the 10-minute chart we looked at right now that recycled, can this recycle, can it get above the high that was made right here at 112.22 on the 20th of February peak D in the daily, and then it plunged down to the 100, was that 101.18. 100, let me type that in, 101.18, I think it was 1.8. And now we're at 111.57, still holding very well. It looks to me that we're going to get the same kind of V-shaped pattern in the weekly chart peak F. Now, if this soars above 100, it can't just sneak above because that'll make it just a, it needs to soar above the 112.22 high the week of the 21st of February. And if it does that, is that a brand new leg A? Are we looking at the yen, USD, JPY, actually starting a brand new move? Because look at the monthly chart, look at the candle of the monthly. This is, if we just stop the month right now, this would be one of the most impressive candles. Chapman Wave, long-legged Roman candle at the bottom of a run. Whoa, bottom of the run. Let me show you. Yeah. Well, yeah, sort of the bottom of the run. That would be very positive. So I'm going to be watching this very closely. At this particular point, let me just give you the numbers for the USD-JPY. Key supports between 109.70 and 108.60. That's the key support. If it breaks under that, that's going to be like almost a single leg A failure. So watch that closely. But if it does rally further, it needs to close above 113.35, somewhere there, probably two out of three sessions to say, no, I'm on my way even higher. If it just pops up and then comes back down again, this is the V-shaped pattern double top that we'll be looking at. Hope that helps you. Question I had about NBEV, N-B-E-V, NBEV, forgot to see what it is. I know what the stock is, Basil. The NBEV screamer is starting to percolate. How high can it go near to, thanks, heck. So this is a leg B. Yes, this is very good because it made a peak D top. Remember, D is where we start to look for reversal signals, Chapman Wave methodology. And it plummeted from the about $2 and just under 280 or just about, let me see what it is, to 284 on the 21st of February to a low of 1. I mean, we're talking about a serious decline percentage-wise to 0.98, and now it's almost doubles at 1.47 in leg B. Hector, I like it, but I'm going to just say to you that it's above the 140, 14-period moving average in the daily and the 131 pink 9-period exponential moving average. Those are your key supports short-term. Where could it go? I think the weekly has 1.72 as pink 9-period moving average, and the weekly 14-period moving average is 185. So I think that's what we're looking at. And it's part of this extreme flurry of the little cluster formation at the bottom where you can double, which we've just done, the double, the low to the first peak, and then pull back, and now we've gotten higher. So I like it. I think you're absolutely correct. In terms of the USD JPY, the question was, where would I get long if whatever instrument you're using? You see, if there is a pullback here and it goes under 109.20, it's taken out the wicks of the last three bars, and since it's going to take a little longer to consolidate, which could take it to the 108 area. So I would just say either you go in right now because this is really strong, the technicals are strong. If it's an add to position, I do it now. If you haven't been in at all and you want to be a little conservative, you do have to wait. Otherwise, you're grabbing it right now in a smaller position because you're getting in right now. And you have to have some kind of a stop if you're getting in fresh. If you're already in and you've got a nice a comfort zone, then you can do a little nibble here. But the best place would be between 109, around 109.50 to 108.80, somewhere between these two moving averages. Hope that helped you. Next question I had was, let me just see if I can get to it, and maybe I don't know if I can post it. There we go. Oh, man, there it is, Dow chart. So a lot of people have been sending me charts. I've been trying to answer them. I've actually been answering them in the show itself. Yes, this is, how can I do that? Let me just show you the Dow, a very long-term Dow. Let me go there right now. So the question I had was, we've been buying for the last, we haven't had shorts at all in the last couple of days. We have been buying. And the question was, what's your comfort zone with? So some of the things I had said yesterday to subscribers, I want to be buying these. I mean, we're going to go long. But I also said for some of them that I would prefer if there was a bit of a dip to this level. So some people say, well, that was the strongest I've been. They've seen me in a buy configuration, at least saying that I wanted to buy. And if it does pull back even a little bit from the from the newsletter number that I sent at 8:25 or 8:30, 8:25 yesterday, I think it was, or 8:20, they're going to get in. So some people got in, and then the market just soared. For quite a number of people, it didn't pull back closer to the levels that I wanted, so they waited, and then it just got away from them. So I reissued buys for some of them for a new buy on the very stocks that they might have missed there. And the Dow long that we have from I think it was like 18,900 on the Dow where we went long via calls, options, diamonds. We were still in that. It's got a huge, I mean, at this point, it's about a 130, 100 maybe more percent gain. We don't know because it's not, this particular contract's not trading right now. If we had a seller, we'd get a price. We wouldn't get the best price. It makes no difference to us because even just the premium from where we paid, it's up 14 points from the contract that we got. So that's at least 12 points premium. And we paid 10.5. So that's minimum. So we'll see. I could turn around. Anything can happen. I like what I'm looking at now. I think that this is both a result of that incredible negative sentiment, as well as, you've got CCL. I think that we had a Denner talking about getting in very low yesterday. It's trading up $1.80, up 13% just today, and yesterday it was up huge. So these Boeing, I mean, where's Boeing right now? Boeing's up 39 at 167. These are amazing levels of turnaround. I'll be back.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190. The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The gold report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The Gold Report is a comprehensive look at the metal sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com and hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com and hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Hi, folks. So I had a caller who couldn't hang on the phone, Kevin in Sacramento. Kevin wanted to know about, had a question on buying puts on telephone. T is the symbol. It's up $1.05 at $29.14. It made a low 3 days ago, just above 26. 26.08 to be exact. I would not be doing it at this particular time. In fact, if anything, just on a very short-term basis, I'd probably be saying I'd rather be buying calls than puts right now. I'm not sure what your strategy. If it's just a naked put, I would say absolutely not. Don't do it at this particular time. It's just it is so oversold that any kind of a bounce could take it, even to the 30.35 nine-period moving average, maybe 31.57. If it gets to 31.57, it's a different kettle of fish altogether. What I wanted to say is that if Verizon is down, Verizon is down this morning, and I'm looking. I haven't been sending out all that many charts to my subscribers. They know that I'm looking at a lot of things. I've been looking at dividend. Isn't this a great time to be looking at dividend-type stocks? Just beaten down, fabulous dividends. And some of them, I'm not sure, like, is Exxon going out of business? Is Verizon going out of business? Is Telefone going out of business? I don't think they're going out of business at this particular point. They could have some tough times, but out of business now. So Verizon's up 45 cents today, 50.44. I looked at these and I thought, you know, people won't be paying bills. A whole bunch of things are going on. I'm not sure that I feel comfortable about it, just as I don't feel comfortable about it. Now, Exxon, going from the 30 level to 38, that's 25%, something like that, 25%. Is that right? That's a huge gain, over 20% again, and hitting the nine-period moving average. Is this a dividend stock? If you look at the monthly charts, maybe there's deeper problems, but maybe it's a bargain, but it's a risk. And the whole thing is down at this level. That's where you want to be thinking about at least your risk reward factor. So now let's go to T, and he's not talking about dividends. He's about shorting telephone. So I'm just going to say, no, I don't think at this time, but please ask me again if it can get to. So the Dow's at 21,700. Up 1,000 points right now. I mean, these are huge moves. If the Dow can get to, if the Dow can get to the 22,500s, telephone rallying at the same time, it can get up about another 80 cents to close to 30. That's about the point where I'm going to say, okay, how much more is there? The diamonds were at 182 the other day. They're now at 217. Telephone was at 2608. It's now 2916. That's still 12%. That's still a percentage, a big move. So I'm just going to say, let's look at it again. Rather, let's get a little higher up. If you're really looking at naked puts, that means we need to be absolutely as close as possible. And then we want to be looking out to give it some time. Maybe not even April. Maybe it's going to have to be May. So let's look at it again together, let's see what happens. Some of you, I saw a thing, JetBlue Credit. I wonder what happens now with those flights that are actually canceled. Are they still going to just give you a credit or are you going to get your money back? That's a big question, huh? All right, so we're looking at JetBlue. Let's just have a look at JetBlue. JetBlue's trading. Look at that move from about just under 7. To 11. I mean, we're talking about percentage moves, 6.61 to 11.62, almost a double, and yet way off the 21 high that it was at just last month. These are big moves. These are really big percentage moves. Now, is this it? Two gaps, and you're up and away, and that's usually what you're looking at for a really strong rally. So this is an important period, very important period. And then we need to get through this, and then we need to see whether or not we're starting to see not a really big increase in the number of infected people that have the coronavirus, but the people who are now out of the 14 period or 15 period stepping aside stage have come back and are feeling really good. I think that's going to be so important. We haven't seen anything quite like this before. All right, question I had was, that's right. I had a question yesterday. Could I look at my Dow quartet? So that is Caterpillar. Where's Caterpillar right now? Caterpillar's nice move up, 4.44 at 105.79. Just a week or so ago, it was at 87 to 105, big move. But look where it's come from. 173 was all-time high. Last big move was in the 151 area. Right down to the weekly, the monthly, 87. This is a 200-period exponential moving average. This is a really good start to a takeoff if it's going to do that. IBM is trading at 110.39, up 4.93, 110.41. Yeah, it's just above the 14-period moving average. And just the other day, it was at about almost 90. Nice move for IBM, Triple M. That really got slammed the other day. Wow, big move. Up 37 cents at 133.09. But it was trading 133. Remember, it was trading at 114. These are big percentage moves, but they're only just coming off basis. What about UTX? Almost added it this morning. Oh, look at this, up 10 at 96.77. That would have been a good add. This is big. Up 9.80, hitting the 14-period moving average. So we want to see follow-through. That's why I'm saying that telephone, it would be too early to go to some kind of a short. Let's go to Irene in San Diego. Irene, how are you? Do we have Irene?
Yes, I'm great. How are you?
Yes, very good. So you're looking at?
Boeing.
And you would like to do, or you have done?
Well, I've already bought it, and so I'm just sort of watching and seeing where I should sell.
So you know what? This is, first of all, congratulations, because it really wasn't looking great there. When it went to down into the 90, low 90s, and then it slipped under that, and it hit round number 89. That's when I said, oh, round number, this is a good. I only saw the round number about 2 days later. So this is fantastic action for Boeing in terms of percentage gain.
Right.
Not if you look at it. If you were short, this is 6 days from the low. If you were short 6 days, this is 6 days after the low. If you were short 6 days before the low, you'd be looking at about 240 going to 89. So while this is spectacular on the upside, the downside was that there could be analogies that are metaphors that I could use. I won't do it because it's Boeing. But I am going to say is that all of this is based on two factors. One is that there's a bailout, whatever form it is, it's a bailout, yeah, giving them cash. And can you hold on?
Sure.
Okay, because this is going to be, I'm going to give you a plan that I would have if I was long this, and see if you agree with me. I'll be right back, folks. Dow's up 1,033. Boeing is up 41 and 169. Fantastic move. I'll be right back. We're on with Irene in San Diego. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technician's Hour. Be right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks, this is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge, heard here at TFNN.com.
Hi, folks, we're back. Dow's up 983. Irene, this is what I was going to say to you. What price can you tell? Will you tell me? Is it okay if you tell me what price you got in at?
Oh, yeah, 100.
Okay, so you got in at 100. This would be the first of all, when you got in at 100, was there any way in your wildest dreams that you would expect in milliseconds that it would be trading at 167?
No. Okay. I almost sold it yesterday, too, but I'm glad I held on.
Yeah, so I'm going to say to you, why don't you treat this as a gift and take off something that you feel comfortable with and hold enough to say that if it really goes much higher, you don't regret taking something off because you feel comfortable. You've made some, which you didn't expect, and now it's like a gift from heaven. So I'm just going to say, take a little bit off, keep your core position, and I would have a stop on another position, a small position, whatever you take off now. Besides that, I would say I'd have a stop at about just to kind of, you don't want to lose too much from this fantastic gain, they say 167, say 158 on the day, and I'd adjust it accordingly. But try to keep your core, because coming in at 100, it might be days, it could be weeks, and it might not even be getting close to 100. But at some point, I think Boeing will have another series of down moves. Would it go back to 89? I'm not sure. But wow, that is fantastic. So take feel whatever you're comfortable with. Just say, I'm happy that if it goes up from here, I've still got enough to say that's fantastic. At the same time, if it goes down, I've taken off right here to reward myself. I think that's the way to do it, because it's the psychological comfort level that you want. It isn't just the practical. I've just given you the levels to look at, but the comfort level is really important.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Congratulations to you. Fabulous move. Very good.
Thank you
very much for calling in. Good luck with it. Let me know how it goes.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you very much. So, folks, just before about to hand you over to Steve and then to Dave and then to Tom, I just want to say for my opening call, my daily newsletter, we've been trying to work our way into this with long positions. I think this is a very challenging time, because if you're successful and it does like Irene just did, it's a fantastic move. What do you do next? And you want to be in the game. So your best thing is to...